You might wonder why humans look the way we do and how we ended up this way. Well, it turns out the things our DNA has left behind over the past few hundred thousand years is mind-bogglingly cool. While it's known that all humans develop a tail in the womb that eventually dissolves, only recently we have discovered where it might have come from in the first place. The world's most primitive primate and one of our early ancestors, the Dryomamis slazi, spent most of its life in trees, which would have been a huge advantage for gathering food compared to other land dwellers some 56 million years ago. It's very likely that this is how primates rocked it so hard in the animal kingdom. For most of human evolution, every human had brown eyes. That is until 6 to 10,000 years ago, a genetic mutation from a single person near the Black Sea changed everything. This mutation affected the production of melanin, the substance that determines hair and skin color, and switched the color of the eyes from brown to blue. Somehow, it spread across Europe, and approximately 8% of the world's population has blue eyes. But it also means that every blue-eyed person may share the same ancestor. So that's kind of weird. We're not 100% sure why we have as little hair on our bodies as we do. But one theory is that while we were finally walking upright in the ridiculously hot African savanna, you know, evolving and whatnot, we had to rid ourselves of hair in order to cool ourselves down. Our hairlessness might have been seen as a sign of good health, making the less hairy more attractive to the opposite sex. And last but not least, before we evolved into humans, the penises of our primate ancestors were covered in hard spines. Yeah, you heard me. Theory suggests that the human males had these spines as a way of removing the sperm of their competitors, which thankfully isn't as big of a deal as it was thousands of years ago. Anyway, after we started more monogamous relationships, it makes sense that the less bumps we had on our penises, the better the sex. The better the sex, the more monogamous the relationship. So, as the great Charles Darwin once said, and I quote,
"Evolution is totally awesome!"